it's only fitting we sell stone. Because at the core of it, only stone can match the characteristics of the people who craft it. Stands the test of time. Rugged, highly sought after, admirable, and yeah, toughness. We've seen it all. Bad economies, ice storms, competition, even an F4 tornado. You see, the people of Semco, we don't crumble after the first blow. If we get knocked down, we just get back up. We rally around what's right and act as one. If we can't find our way around tough times, then we'll make one, because that's what we do. We care about others and strive to make a difference, like we have with the Backpack for Friday and foster kids in need. All that matters now is what lies ahead. How do we come together? And how do we win? This company is not going to be knocked out in one punch. We get back up again, and when we do, the world is going to hear our roar. This is a limestone company, and this is what we do. We are Semco.
First of all, I just want to thank Simco for all the things that they do. Their quality of materials and product is fantastic. Their sales staff caters to all of our needs and all of our wants. So again, thank you, Simco, for all the things that you do.
Merry Christmas, Simco, from all of us here at the Association of Rackless Metal. The old seminary grounds as it's known here in town. I want to thank you for all your hard work this year. Big project, our 200-year anniversary. As you may or may not remember, this was recorded all the original stone here for the church and the grotto right here on campus. So when it was time for our big renovation, we knew we needed to call on somebody locally who understood who we were.
The site improvements at the Association of the Miraculous Metal is a project that both Robinson Construction and Simco Stone can be proud of. To be involved in such a beautiful restoration that not only attracts local visitors, but also visitors from around the world has been exciting. The restoration of the grotto and specific requests by the AMM staff and donors brought some unique challenges to the project that made it even more rewarding to complete. At the beginning of the project, we were looking for a stone to be used on the apparition structures, the bridges, and the seat walls. At Simco's recommendation, the Timber Creek stone was selected that has a unique blend of tan and gray color, and how fitting that it is also locally mined at the Cedar Ridge Quarry. Robinson Construction completed the structural design of the two bridges, while Simco assisted in the material selection. The Brentwood caps added that extra character to the beautiful bridges that overlook the new water feature in the restored grotto area. Simco also worked through two new processes to meet the owner's request on this project. The black granite stone with the St. Mary's of the Barrens seal in the Welcome Plaza was the first piece to be etched on Simco's new CNC routing machine. Simco also worked with AMM on the suggestion of putting the donor names on the top surface of the stone benches as opposed to the conventional brass plaques.
The history of the Association of the Miraculous Metal holds a great and honorable place in our minds. My father had his first job working for St. Mary's Seminary and the Association of the Miraculous Metal. There were always stories of the priests and brothers whom were both religious leaders and friends to my father. AMM grew and changed through the years. St. Mary's of the Barrens Church, the National Shrine of Our Lady of the Miraculous Metal, the Bell Tower, and the Walk to the Grotto have been part of my life forever. But today, the Association of Miraculous Metal has embarked on the development of the Rosary Trail, which brings new life to the whole campus. Through great religious leaders and lay leaders, the plan for the Rosary Trail was envisioned and completed. The newly completed trail, along with the apparitions and other religious features, enhances the religious and spiritual journey. I encourage everyone to visit the Rosary Trail and enjoy the beauty of the historical grounds and benefit from this great religious experience.
Chasing the sunshine. chasing the sunshine, and go out and play. You know, don't wait for tomorrow.
My name's Dave LaFera. I'm a Tiffany Lawn and Garden Supply out of Indianapolis, Indiana. Been a Semco family member for about 8-9 years now. We've been real happy with the service and whatnot that we've gotten from y'all. Josh Wheeler is my sales rep. Ready to go, Josh. He's done another, you know, wham, bam, thank you, did. Josh, kind of a deal this year. But it's been a tough season. Tiffany's is, you know, had kind of experienced what everybody else has experienced in this industry, or I should say this profession. We're more of a profession than we are an industry. I think that's a little bit more of a family term, and it just seems like that's what this industry or this profession is. So, we had a tough year this year. You know, the weather in the spring was just atrocious with all the moisture and whatnot. Everybody got so far behind, and then when it was time to go, it got hot, like always in the, you know, July, August end of the deal, and we're finally catching up. You know, the people are starting to come back in. We're seeing multiple semis going out the door again finally, but it's kind of a little bit too late. As I'm out tagging now, and you guys do have quite a bit of stuff out here. Sorry, salespeople, it came down to tag. It's all gone. I took it all. Anyway. But we're restocking back up. We're looking for a good spring. Just don't know how it's going to turn out as the year goes on. With the election being what the election was and the fighting that goes on between both these parties, it just, you never know what the economy is going to bring in. That's a shame because we're really going through some great times right now and everybody just needs to work together. If they had the Semco attitude that you guys have, this country would work out a lot better than what it's doing right now. I always kind of love coming down here. There are just things that happen at this company that don't happen in other companies. And that's the way you work together with each other, the way you respect each other. It's just a neat deal to see. I always love Ed's family here. So, oh, by the way, I'm required by law now to say this. Ed is my guardian angel. I hate to admit it, but he is. So thank you, Ed, for being that. So anyway. Hope you all have a good year. Hope you have a great party. You deserve it. Let your hair down. Have some fun. There's a lot to do this spring. Talk to you all later. Bye.
myself. So my name's Paul Flynn. I started this company a couple years back, and been kind of finding my way in the hardscape industry, and it's really taken off this year. Able to send crews here. Lunch is provided, which super helps because those lunch breaks end up really long otherwise. Get Skyline, stop by, pick it, Jeff and Lori periodically. And it's just a really good environment. Send clients, send customers over. The employees like it. They're loaded quickly. That helps me on the bottom line. And also they're a little less frustrated compared to other places that I make them go. So overall, this has probably way too much of my business, and I'm happy with that.
You don't need to take this because Semco is awesome. Did I do it? Did I do it? Is it good? Did I do it?
Hi, everybody. I hope you're enjoying your evening. We've got a nice little funny video here for you. So, if you have to go to the bathroom, you probably should have did that 5 minutes ago. All right, this video. This is all about liquid ass. I bought this stuff as a little prank for everybody. So, I'm going to set the stage for you here a little bit and let you know what's going on. I'm going to get a few guys from the shop and a few guys from the office and anybody else that I can willingly get to go out in the yard with me. We're going to drive out in the yard in my truck, and I'm going to spray a little bit of this behind their seat without them knowing. Now, I don't know if anybody's going to gag or puke or just try to kill me. I don't know. But we'll find out. Let's see how this goes.
Ooh, fuck. Too many beers last night?
Mm-hmm.
Damn, it smells like we just came from some damn barnyard. You better go have a doctor clean your ass out.
Whoa, did you shit your pants?
What did you do?
You son of a bitch.
Is that?
Sorry.
Damn.
You shit in your pants, didn't you?
There's something. You need to go to doctor. What the f*** is wrong with you?
I have too much
variegation
in the back of the
section.
Back of the section. Okay.
Fucking smell like shit.
I'd f***ing get taquitos this morning.
God. Piece of shit. Ah, fuck. What the f- is the smell in here?
Oh, that was fucking not nice. Is it really that bad?
Yeah. I'm about to jump in the bed of this damn truck. Holy
f***. You f***. God damn. Could have f***ing waited. Fucker.
If that is your butthole, it's rotten. You need to wash it.
It only smells a little bit.
Huh? Smells like cow shit. What the f***?
Oh, motherfuck.
Oh, damn. Oh.
Sick motherfucker. Sick motherfucker. Roll my window down.
God damn, I'm out of here. I'm about ready to throw up.
What did you eat? I can't. You fucking farted again.
That's your gas last night.
That's your butt?
Yeah, a little bit.
That smells like... That is not your butt. There is no way that's your butt.
I'm
somebody's like it's fucking lingering.
I hope you shit in your pants. Be home to your bride. She probably ain't got no nose hairs anymore.
She's immune to it.
How can you even sit there?
Damn, turn the fan in full blast or something. Open your window, drive fast. God, you're right. I feel like I just fell down face first in a hog pile.
No, it's not. That's fucking hog farm is what that is. Your butt smells like a hog farm.
It's not that bad. Come on.
It's not that fucking good. I don't like fucking cat shit.
Come on, let's hurry up. Let's get back up there.
I can't get in there.
It's not that bad.
It is. Why does it smell like cow shit? I want to fucking know. Why do you smell like cow shit? I can't. That's not right. Get over here. I'm walking. I get my headache.
Next time you ask me to come out in the yard with you, I'll know better. I'll know what to answer you. Go f*** yourself.
Yeah, I don't give a f*** what you do with the National Inn. Sit right there all day long.
That's horrible. Not bad.
I was hoping for an indication. I was seeking higher elevation. I've been shaking, waking in the nightlight. I've been breaking, hiding from the spotlight. The more I stray, the less I fear. And the more I reach, the more I fade away. Darkness right in front of me, oh, it's calling out and I won't walk away. I would always open up the door, always looking up for higher flaws. Wanna see it all, give me more. I was always up for making changes, walking down the street, meeting strangers, flipping through my life, turning pages. Like a hunter waiting for the season. I was there, but I was always leaving. I've been living, but I was never breathing. The more I stray, the less I fear. And the more I reach, the more I fade away. Darkness right in front of me. I'm burning.
stronger than this storm. 160 mile per hour sustained winds.
Hawaii under a hurricane warning as Category 5 Lane bears down. The storm packing maximum sustained winds of 160 miles per hour.
Hello, I am live here at Simcoe Conference Room in Perryville, Missouri. Earlier today, our sales manager reported he would be missing today's budget meeting due to the incoming Hurricane Lane, which is reported as a possible Category 5. Days ago, we thought due to the extreme shortness of Hurricane Lane that we might get lucky and not have to see Hurricane Lane at all. However, it appears Hurricane Lane is similar to what you would see from an injured dog. It comes off timid, but if you get too close to it, it'll bite your hand off. In an effort to help everyone understand how catastrophic this thing must be to miss a budget meeting, we have our top reporter on the scene. Seth, how bad is it looking out there?
Well, Chad, it appears Hurricane Lane is either completely full of shit or very slow moving. With the current weather, I can only assume your reference to a Category 5 is in regards to the height of your sales manager. Let's go ahead and kick this thing over to Allison at CNN.
How slow is it moving? Yeah, from a tropical system perspective, this is very slow, and that's a bad thing.
The slower these systems move, the more time they have to dump that tremendous amount of rain. So, yeah.
I'm calling in with an update because we have lost all video feed. The rain and wind are coming in all directions. The rivers are cresting levels. The lightning is fierce, and Lane just keeps pounding me from behind. It just feels like a Monday morning.
Oh, ask for sales? I come to the airport, wind up sitting here, delayed, miss my flight? Lane screws up everything.
You know, all I can say is Lane screws up everything.
See this? Melbourne, Daytona Beach, all the way up to Jacksonville. This moves 20 miles to the west, and you and everyone you know are dead. All of you. Because you can't survive it. It's not possible, unless you're very, very lucky. And your kids die, too.
All right, guys. I just got back from San Juan, Puerto Rico this week. That's why I'm a little tan and everything here. I can tell you what, the biggest hurricane ever went through the Caribbean, it doesn't have anything to do when you deal with Hurricane Lane. There's only one hurricane that's ever topped him, and I think he lives with that, and that's Hurricane Sandy.
Reporting live from Simcoe Beach, I'm currently standing here weathering what's been reported as the shortest storm in history. A very small stature storm, as you can see, but it's meaner than hell with a heart of ice. Hopefully we can weather Hurricane Lane just a few moments longer and get back to some good weather.
So earlier this year, everyone became captivated by the Mega Millions Lotto that reached an all-time high of $1.6 billion, to the point where employees were all coming together, throwing money in a bucket, and going out and buying tickets. But you know, I wonder what would have happened had the computers, I don't know, had an error that affected thousands of people. So I want to thank you all for being here. We've got several things to discuss today. We're getting ready for 2019, and I guess up first, let's talk about margins for next year.
Oh, I'm sorry everyone isn't here, because what I wanted to say to everyone all at once.
You guys have been blisters on my ass. Not just blisters, but ingrown hairs. So, yes, this is champagne. Because you see, I won the lottery. And you know how? I willed it to happen. So my old school ass is out of here. In closing, suck it.
You guess you haven't heard, huh?
Yeah. All of them?
A lot of 25,
things. 25, 32, 44, 52, 66.
Yeah.
Everybody does. A
lot of wear.
They printed thousands.
So where were we? Oh, on a side note, we do want to make sure everyone's happy with their job here.
Oh, yeah,
absolutely.
I'll make note of that. So, anyway, yeah, we need to get our margins up. You know, we had big issues last year.
I have an announcement to make. I won the lotto. I'm a millionaire. You're looking at a millionaire right here. You know something? Coming in here every day. Hey, Kenny, sack this for me. Hey, Kenny, sack that for me. How about y'all take this sack, because I'm out of here.
Lotto misprint. Yeah. Apparently you haven't heard.
You didn't get that, the 25, 32, 44, 62, 66. Yeah, we all got it.
Yeah, printed thousands of them.
Hmm.
Yeah. What's that, MC?
I feel sucker that. Yeah. All right, thanks.
Yeah.
Can you close the door?
Y'all take this sack, because I'm out of here, bitches.
Back to it, shall we? Margins, they got to come up. We're becoming less and less profitable by the day, and we need to figure out how we can start getting these margins up.
Did someone come with a problem? So I'll give you one guess who doesn't give a f***. Scott, SPS is slow. Scott, is the internet down? Scott, I just ran over my phone. Well, I'll give you one way to fix that problem. Write it down on a piece of paper, roll it all up, and shove it right up your because there's two thumbs up, and this guy is going to snort some coke with fucking Zuckerberg on the CNC machine. That's this guy right here.
Haven't heard about the misprint yet, huh?
Misprint.
25, 32,
44, 62, 66. Yep, we all got it.
Haven't heard about it yet.
It's alright.
Alright.
Roll up and shut right up your ass.
So, for 2019, we really need to zone in on the top sellers. The SKUs that we feel like are.
Oh, yeah, baby! Guess who won the lotto? Yes! F you! F you, motherfuckers! Guess what? I just signed papers on a little plot of land out in Colorado. It's all pretty because I'm part of the Going Green movement. I'm heading out. But before I go, Wes did sell me a spot on the billboards. It's just a giant old picture of me with Snoop Dogg and Willie Nelson with a doobie in one hand and a big old whoop with the other. But before I go, in all honesty, suck it.
Numbers, everyone?
Yeah,
we
good.
25, 32, 44, 62, 66, 23.
Yeah.
Yeah. See that? Big lotto misprint.
Yeah.
But for the record, you are the second person to tell me to suck it today.
Who else? Are?
All right, everyone. Shall we?
No.